What's up, you guys? We're back with some more NFL picks this week for week 9. This is Beat the Odds NFL edition on Odds Checker. Before we get started, guys, how did we do last week?
We went 3-1. We're now 500 of the last 2 weeks. The Patriots outright won. I had them +5.5, so that's always fun. And even with my pick of the week was the Packers Thursday night game, because I guess I pick Thursday night games now. And apparently, even with that line climbing all the way to 7, the Packers just won outright. So it didn't even matter what spread I gave it to you guys at. So it still counts. 3-1. I'll take it.
The way you said we, I don't know. Yeah. You went 3-1. I went 1-3. I got brutalized. The Chargers game just beat me up. I really underrated how bad that run defense is, and the fact that like you can just run at will against that team. Jerry Tillery's killing that football team right now.
It's just one guy. You're just like that guy.
Right, man, there. It is that guy. The other teams know it's that guy. Like it's that guy.
And you can tell the other teams do too. I mean, anyone just goes in the base personnel against them, it's like it's all over from there. So yeah. I know. Those poor Chargers.
It's tough.
All right. Well, let's get into it for week 9. It's a start of the new month, start of a new week. So let's get those picks rolling.
Yeah. And some places it's a new quarter if you're in some super contests. But I'm going to start off with a team that played in the Sunday night game last night. I'll go with the Vikings +5.5 at the Ravens. I do like the Ravens as a team, but they are, I think, up and downy based on really how teams treat their offense and how they can get away on their offense. I think this defense, they love their man coverage. They love their pressure. And it was shocking to see the Bengals kind of take it to them a little bit, even though the Bengals got a little bit lucky on some stuff. But I do think this Vikings team, I like them. I think the defense keeps improving. I know Dak was out last night, but this defense is coming to its own. It's a whole bunch of vets. And I think offensively it's Kirk Cousins. It's how far he can carry you. But I think this game's going to be a little bit closer. These teams are a little more evenly matched than their records might indicate, and maybe the public persona of them. So I'm going to take the points and go Vikings +5.5.
That passing offense is what should scare Baltimore more than anything. I mean, they can't cover a damn thing right now. My first game, New England at Carolina. Carolina's the 3-point home favorite. How far have we come with this Carolina Panthers defense, right? We were like 2 or 3 weeks in at wondering, is this the best pass defense in the league?
That's the unit.
They traded for Stephon Gilmore, and now they're 3-point home dogs to a rookie quarterback. As far as the quarterback advantage here, I think the two quarterbacks are probably operating somewhere close. Mac obviously can keep them on schedule a little bit more. Mm-hmm. But defensively, I think Carolina probably has more juice, especially up in the box. 3-point home dog, that's just too rich for me. I'm just taking that number blankly.
And just straight up just taking the points.
Yep.
And going from there. I know that game I'm torn. I will get to it in a sec, but I actually might as well just do it right now. I'm on the opposite side, and it is not my pick of the week or anything, but I'm doing the Patriots -3 at Carolina. I think exactly what you said about the QBs. I think Mac Jones is like, he's pushing the ball now, and it's like, oh shoot, all right, well, we're unlocking some a little bit more with this offense. So that's been really fun. I do trust this defense. It's the same stuff Belichick always runs, but it's like he's emphasizing a little different parts of it. So it's none of that I'm seeing ghost defense that he ran against like Sam Darnold, all the mugged up stuff. It's more just one-y blitzes and a whole bunch of man. And so it's like, okay, I could see what they're kind of reconfiguring what they're doing right now. And I really like it. I do. I think they're playing well. I get what you're saying too about going to Carolina and stuff. This Panthers team is like, I have no idea what to make of them. They're trying to trade CMC. Maybe they're not. Maybe they are getting Watson. Now they're not. Darnold's going up and down. So I'm going to go with Patriots -3. I trust the team a little bit more, but I get exactly what you're getting at.
I have another AFC game. You took an AFC North team with your first pick, Cleveland +3 at Cincinnati. I just still think Cleveland is a better team than what they're showing on film recently. I don't think the quarterback situation matters nearly as much. Like we watched Keenum operate within the structure of that offense, and they just put points on the board. So as long as they can like click a little bit, I'm not worried about the offense. And then defensively, I think Cleveland talent wise blows Cincinnati out of the water, just in terms of guys that they have on the field defensively. So if you're calling this an even matchup, it's really hard for me to figure out what Cincinnati does better than Cleveland, other than the Burrow to Chase connection, right? The Burrow to Chase connection, yes. Obviously, through the roof. Chase is going to win Offensive Rookie of the Year. I understand that. Yeah. But Cleveland, they just have so much firepower, and they're in a position right now where they really they're still in the mix for the AFC North, as weird as that sounds. They have a slim chance to win it, but they're very much in the wild card hunt. So they need to get their crap together. They're in a spot where they need this game, you know?
Yeah, and, well, it's a classic, like, gambling adage is who needs to win. And it's like, I think the Browns have a little bit more desperation than the Bengals right now. I did not pick that game, but I see it the same way. That was one of those I was kind of like, I was looking at it the same way, because even if Baker's not playing great right now, the Browns, like you said, the Browns' offense just like, they're too talented up front to, like, not be competent. You know, right. It's just like, to at least put together a game plan. No, but I like that one. I'm going with a NFC West game. I'm going to go with the 49ers hosting the Cardinals. The 49ers are +2.5. This one is, I think it's one of those where I saw this game happen with Trey Lance starting for the 49ers. The 49ers were in it the whole game. I think I bet them on that one. This was only a couple weeks ago. I think their defense kind of knows how to handle Kyler in this offense, this really explosive Cardinals offense, but it can be a little fluky at times. They have enough speed to handle that a little bit. And I also think this 49ers offense, they had Jimmy G running zone read stuff in the red zone. Did you see that? He had 2 rushing touchdowns. There were legit QB runs. And it's like, it was hilarious. It was like, I think like Kyle Shanahan must have challenged him. Like, we don't need Trey Lance. You got it, bud. Like, let's see you do it. Like he went and got it. I think the offense is figuring out their form. I don't know if it's a great form, but somewhat of their form, their home dogs. I'm going to take it +2.5. I think this is where the Cardinals are going to take a couple in the chin for a few weeks while they reconfigure what they are.
Yeah, actually, that was one where I was right on the bubble. I think this Niners team is catching this Cardinals team at the exact right time. Yeah. Kyler's ankle's banged up a little bit. He might be in that type of situation where, you know, last week people didn't necessarily realize, like, Dak was, you know, a potential out for this week.
Yeah,
I mean, we could very easily see Kyler in that type of situation this week. And then, you know, you brought up Jimmy running at the goal line. I mean, they had that shovel toss read where they're using a motion man and they mistimed the motion man. Jimmy just said, to hell with it. I'm putting my head down and I'm winning the points. And he scored. So, yeah, I think they're figuring it out. They remembered Brandon Ayuk is alive. That's always nice when your head coach remembers the first round wide receivers, you know, still on the roster.
He used to like, and then now he hates. Like. Yeah.
So I think a lot of things are trending in the right ways for the Niners in that spot. I'm going to take the Chargers -2.5 at Philadelphia. Pain from last week. I was so big on the Chargers, and then they just let me down. I still think, just point blank period, this Chargers offense is a whole lot better than a lot of people, you know, in the NFL. Bill made them just throw in the tight windows all game. Every single throw that Herbert
drop
had.
Drop 8.
Yep. I don't think Philadelphia is going to play that way. Philadelphia can't play that way, especially, you know, the even front that they're running. Between that and then just the quarterback, you know, differences here. I mean, Jalen Hurts looked like he did fine this past weekend. One thing that the Eagles have really struggled with early on in the game is just they do not run the ball like the first, like, half. You know, it's like if they get a lead, they'll run the ball, but they don't come out running the ball. That's the one thing the Chargers cannot stop. Is the run game, especially inside run. So I just think the matchups, the quarterbacks here, things are trending Chargers' way. Hopefully they make me back some money after last week.
That's funny. So this is my exact pick of the week. Do I jump right into it, Caitlin?
Yeah, no, that was my pick of the week.
Oh, really?
So, no, yeah, we're kind of just going off of what Justice said. I'm with him with the Chargers -2.5 also, but – just the Chargers are also better coached, in my opinion. And just with going along what you said about the quarterbacks, I like what I see from Jalen. I see a lot of improvements, but he's just not at what Herbert is currently at. So, yeah, I'm taking Chargers -2.5.
And, I mean, it's my pick of the week, and that's another gambling edge. You're betting on quarterbacks and the head coach, right? Like, that's kind of like the classic what you bet on in football, and that's exactly what I am on this game. I'm doing Chargers -2.5. can't really add much more to what you said, Justice, and you said, Caitlin. It's just kind of that's what this matchup is. It's I'm betting on Justin Herbert carrying them, and it's like a nice solid win. And again, the Chargers are, I would say, reeking of desperation, but they're kind of like, yeah, okay, they're getting a little fire lit under them with how kind of things are breaking in the AFC.
My pick of the week, Las Vegas Raiders, -3 at the New York Giants. So this is that, like, west to east early kick thing. I don't know how much that matters anymore with the way travel is set up. It seems like it matters less and less every year. Raiders are coming off of extended rest. Quarterbacks, right? Let's talk about quarterbacks. There's a disadvantage here. You know, Carr has the advantage there. This offense is clicking. It does not seem like Gruden not being the head coach really matters. And then
they're at ease. They're like relaxed now.
Josh Jacobs had that quote last week or 2 weeks ago where he was like, yeah, it's nice that no one's like just a screaming psycho on the sideline. It's like, whoa. All right. Maybe the whole team was over this whole Gruden thing. But they're really in a position where like that special teams coach took over this team. He's going to get them to the playoffs. That's a narrative that people need to be ready for because they could easily win. If the Chargers drop, right, if they lose me money back-to-back weeks, the Raiders are in the driver's seat to win the AFC West. Like, this is going to be a weird spot. So I think the Raiders are just a better team in general. Their pass rush has been more consistent than I thought they were going to be. You know, we were talking 2-3 weeks into the season where, like, they have the best pass rushing duo in the league. They just play stock cover three. Let's see how long that can last. Same well, coverage. It's November now, and they still have the best pass rushing duo in the league, so I guess we have to respect it at this point.
No, I totally see that. I'm higher on the Raiders than I thought I would be with a replacement coach, but here we are. Here we are November 1st, but this is where we're at.
All right, well, those are our picks for Week 9. This was Beat the Odds NFL edition on Odds Checker, and we'll catch you guys next week with our Week 10 picks.